that call themselves by the name of Christ. When, you know, when we hear people that are saying they're Christians and they're not making decisions based on Scripture, or they say they are and they're not loving people, which means they really are obeying Scripture, right? So falling off either side of the horse, we need to call people on it, right? We need to call people that say that they are Christians.
This is that the further that we go in to this mess that we're in, that we keep doing things, because this is the part that's difficult. Our compassion must be there, has to be there. It is God's heart to going after people. The problem is what people are doing is they're taking their...
Yeah.
that he sees the blood of Christ and the righteousness of Christ. Every obedient act of Christ on my behalf? Are you kidding me? You don't know what I just thought. You don't know what I just did. You don't know how I just treated that guy. You don't know how I just talked to my wife. You don't know how I just lied on this. I mean, my gosh, it's endless, Chris. The stuff that goes on in our hearts and the mess that we got, and you think, okay, man, look, I'm 49 this year, like in a couple of weeks. I professed faith in Christ when I was 14. You would think I would have. How often does that encourage you to strive for more? How often does beating yourself up help you live more righteously?
Yes.
Who has been guilted into doing the right thing for the right reason? Right? Notice the right thing for the right reason. Right? We can all for a time do the right thing for a season, even for the wrong reason, because we want to feel better about ourselves, we want to look good to others, we want others to think higher of ourselves and better of us than we actually probably is justified. But over the long haul, there's only so long you can maintain that facade until you come to see and appreciate that you are a beneficiary of things. You know,
mató todos los estudiantes in Mexico, the government killed a lot of students.
El gobierno mató a los que creen en cosas diferentes.
In a lot of countries, the government killed a lot of people who believe in different ways, in different things.
Hicimos una canción para ellos.
And we made a song for them because we cannot allow this. We have to put our voice and say this is not that.
Esto se llama Sangrienta Raza.
This is Bloody Race.
Pero esta canción es especial. No se puede quedar quieto.
You can't stay just watching us. This is a special song. You have to move.
Porque nuestra guerra es espiritual.
Because our war is a spiritual war.
Y cuando usted se mueve,
and when you move,
el infierno tiembla.
The hell is shaking.
If you know it, sing along. If you don't, just mumble along and act like you know it, and no one will judge you. I won't judge you. And that's a song. It's called Comfy Cozy. I also have punny merch. I made comfy koozies. They're like koozies for your mugs because the song is called Comfy Cozy. Get it? Haha. And this is it.
Because it really is what the Bible is all about. It's the foundation. Love God, love others, love you. And today I want to talk about the second one, loving others. Now, I have to say, first of all, this is one of the harder ones. Tomorrow, when we talk about loving yourself, that's the toughest one. This is the second one, loving others. I'm surrounded by people that I love a lot, a lot. And, you know, I've been so fortunate my whole life to have some of the greatest friends around me. And if you look around at Chris and Scott and Andreas and Jamie and Don and all the people there that are really close to me, you see that I have some of the best friends in the world, and I know I'm forgetting some names. But you know that, you know, that's a game changer. It is so good to have people who love you, people who have your back, people that aren't afraid to tell you things, but people who simply love you no matter what. I know that I can tell these guys anything, anything, and they'd be right there. If I told them about something that I'm going through, they're right there to pray with me, right there to talk to me, right there to support me. They don't judge me for it. We have that kind
of... We are the chosen one, bringing many sons to glory. Behold the man upon the cross, thy sin upon his shoulders, the shame that he...
Yeah. What he sees he's going to embark upon. And this is crazy to me because I've never seen him like that. And what I've read about his life, I've never seen him act like that. He stood before people who were deathly ill, people that if he touched them, he would become deathly sick himself. And yet he embraced these people and healed them, not afraid. He stood before a raging sea on this rickety old boat with a bunch of other guys who are like screaming for their lives, thinking they're going to die. And he says but a word, be still. That doesn't rattle him. He stands before mobs of people that want to kill him and take his life, and he pleads with them to hear the gospel message, and he's not afraid. He stands before people who are possessed by demons and are violent and vicious, and he says but a word, and demons go out of them. He stood in front of the devil himself. You may not think that that's...
That screamed, God, and he took his stuff to the Christ. stone. He wore Tommy Hilfiger, took it off, and called with Tommy Hellfighter. Church at a fire, you can come against the Father with clenched fists, but go right to left, is throwing the locusts up. I'm edifying the saints by throwing the chosen up. I'm breaking down the face by blowing them up. I invite them to the cypher, but they showing me up. So I hunt them like vipers, the poison make them froze up. I rock to the top of the top of the molotov and throw it in the hall, and then I scoff. This is where I need you guys, ready? You either hanging on the cross or...
Christian. Raise your hand. Of course, hands went up all over the crowd, you know? Okay, put your hands down. Every head bow, every eye closed. He said, I want you to raise your hand if you're a Christian, which means you read your Bible every day. You pray two or three times a day, all the time. You never forget to bless your food. That means that you have a daily devotion. That means that you ponder and meditate on the Word of God every night before you go to bed. Now, if you're a Christian, I want you to raise your hand. Not as many hands went up, you know. You have to watch these guys. I have an exercise in this. I'm going to give you some phrases, and I want us to watch each other's faces as I do this, okay? This is just shows you kind of what I'm talking about. I'm going to say some things, and I want you to see what this does. I was talking with my friend, and she said that she's not one of the people, you know, I'm talking about the second coming and all this kind of stuff. Jesus is trying to drive home what's going to happen. Jesus is trying to make a point to his friends. Get them to understand. Finally, I think, and it says after 6 days, so this went on for a little while, Jesus is picked up on the fact that some of these guys are visual learners. I'm a visual learner. I'm one that likes to see an example. I like to see someone draw me a picture or take a photo and show me. That burns an image in my mind that I can deal with. I can put my hands on. I can grip onto it, latch onto it, you know? So in chapter 17, we have something happen, and if you've heard sermons on this, that's awesome. I never had heard a sermon until a few months ago on the transfiguration of Christ, but I want to read to you what happened. And then I want to
notes on it. It's like, hey, let me just tell you what's going on. And so Caleb walks up to me and he says, hey, Loyal, can you prove to me that there's a God? And I'm sitting on the coast of Oregon with rolling silver waves crashing onto the beach, with this beautiful moon above, and I'm a Celtic Christian, and God screaming to me, I exist through the ocean's waves, through the moon above, through the breeze that's hitting me. And I say, Caleb, and I just kind of laugh. I said, bro, what's holding that moon up in the sky, dude? What's keeping it from crashing into our planet? I'm like, do you realize that that moon above is controlling these ocean waves as they go back and forth across the ocean? Do you realize that there's some order in the universe that is allowing for those waves?
Thank you. All right, next song is...
hard for me to break through them because I know them so well. And that's why I need that. You know, something begins to happen when you connect with Him and His Holy Spirit begins to flow through you like we talked about before. And that fruit of the Spirit that is His stamp begins to flow through you and you realize that you have substance that you didn't have before. All of a sudden, you become more loving, you become kinder. Love, joy, peace, patience, kindness, goodness, gentleness, faithfulness, self-control. You see those things beginning to happen and you go, wow, that's definitely not me. You know the difference. And you realize that you've been bought at a price. Christ's death on the cross. And the result of that is a makeover, a full body makeover. And when you begin to experience His love inside of you, and when you realize that He has given you a makeover because His Holy Spirit lives inside of you deeper than anything else, out of your innermost being will flow rivers.
Deep into the sound.
this energy going. Let's get it moving. This next song. Actually, I said that. Get it moving?
Yeah.
I'm kind of confused. I hear part of the song. You guys want to hear the whole song? So this song's called Blue Flame. It's about burning your passion and all these things and letting God take control of your situation. Let's do this.
Virginia and yeah, a lot of these songs that we're playing tonight are off of our new record that we put out on June 7th. We have some at Yon Table on Punk Rock Island. Thank you, Rain. It's literally an island over there. But yeah, the next three songs that we're gonna play are off the new record. The next one's called Smokescreen Season. But the whole record that we wrote, it's kind of just about story and how your life is a story, and how a lot of times we really, really love movies and underdogs and great books and all this stuff, but when it comes to character development in our own lives, it's a lot more difficult to have the perspective of like, this is good and we should hold on to it, or this is, you know, hard and we're gonna move through it and it's gonna shape who we are, and how we choose to let it affect us is how we choose to live our lives in the future. So anyway, that's what a lot of these songs are about. But yeah, we really love you guys, and we love the fact that we can be here, and we're very, very thankful that you're honoring us with your time. So yeah, this song is called Smokescreen Season.
Thank you. Yo, for real, thank you all so much. It really is such an honor just to be able to come back.
Thank you. light shows and big soundboards, and they didn't have anybody to run it, so they started hiring me. So on Saturday night, here I am partying with my, you know, makeup and black fingernail polish. Sunday morning, here I am running sound with makeup and black fingernail polish.